Hi, in this video I would like to show you how you can use Terrascope to set up a spreadsheet to price a European FX option using a stochastic volatility model based on the analytical Heuston formula implemented by the Quantlib library. I'm starting with my Terrascope wizard on the right, and first I go to the type selector where I try to locate the FX option type as follows. Here you can see the function called create with the input parameters down here, but I'm interested in a different function called price. And then I go over to models, and you can see here the pricing method is by default set to analytic dividend European. I want to change that into analytic Heuston. Now you can see only the mandatory parameters. If I click the box here, I can display all parameters, including the optional ones. I would like to paste in the spreadsheet not all these parameters, but only the complex log formula here that describes how the complex logarithm is represented, and the integration input that describes how the two-dimensional integration over the space of the underlying FX rate and the volatility is carried out. And the trick to do that is by modifying the associated values away from the default ones. So I click on the three lines here and I choose anything else, for example, Anderson Peter Park. And I do the same for integration, I choose Simpson. Now I click back on the button here, and what I have achieved is that the complex log formula and the integration are now stay visible only because their associated values have been tweaked away from the default original one. So I click on go and create demo workbook. And that has created me a new workbook, and the price of the FX option is what you see here on cell B2.0573. And the input to that price are the cells below. If you click here, this is a link to a cell on the sheet called tradable, right here, which is that cell where the FX option product has been created. Go back to the output sheet. The next cell here, it is a link to a cell on the sheet called model, which is that cell where an object of type model vanilla option has been created that contains all the details that specify the analytic Heuston model. And if we go back to the output sheet, the final input is a link to a cell in the sheet market here. It's that cell that contains a collection of market input data that includes the yield curve, the volatility curve, and the spot value of the underlying FX rate. Let's go now to the model sheet. And what I would like to do next is to create a table that contains the option prices that depend on the varying values of these two parameters here. And the easiest way to do that is by selecting these two cells, right-click with the mouse, and choose the special Terrascope shortcut called Recalc, Refresh, Copy Validation Values. This has copied into my clipboard the possible values associated with these two entries here. So if I click any empty cell, for example this one, and say paste, that has pasted in the spreadsheet these possible values. So I can very easily now copy this, select here, and paste as transposed like that. Then delete those cells. So I move everything to the left for viewing convenience. And then here now I have to fill up that range with model objects. Very easily I can do that by using the clone function. I rely on the fact that I do have a model object already created up here in the cell B2. So all I need to do is to create a replica of that object and place that replica into these cells here. So I go to that cell on the top left corner and type ds, which is my standard Deriscope function. And the first argument will be the name of this special function that called clone that I need to use. And the next argument is the handle name of the object out of which I want to create a clone, which is this cell here. I hit F4 to keep absolute address. The next argument would be the name of the parameter that I want to modify. And the first parameter that I modify is the one called complex lock formula. So I link to that cell and I hit F4 to use absolute address. And the value of the parameter that I modify is this one here. And I hit F4 twice because I need to have a dollar sign next to the row number. The next input will be the second parameter that I modify, which will be the integration one here. I hit F4 to keep absolute address. And the associated value will be that cell. I hit F4 three times to have a dollar sign only on the left of the column letter. So I close the parentheses, I hit return. That has created me a handle name and the associated object. The contents of the associated object are displayed on the task pane on the right. So now I say copy on that formula and I paste that formula to the whole range. I increase the column width so everything is visible. And you see here you do have an error, and the reason for that error you can read to the right. It's technical nature. The combination is disallowed because it leads to infinite prices. And the same is this error here. So I can delete these two cells because technically they are not viable. The rest of the cells contain the handle names of the model objects. So for example, if you click on that cell here, you can read on the right that the complex log formula is set to branch correction as it should, and the integration is set to Gauss Conrod as it should. And the same applies for the remaining objects here. So how do I create the prices that correspond to these objects here? Very easily, I copy this range, I go down here and I paste everything. And I scroll a little bit downwards so we can see everything on the screen. I delete all the cells, I do not need them. I go here and I type my standard Deriscope function, ds, and then I pass as input what is required in order to carry out the pricing of the option. So I go to the output sheet and I have the range already what I need here, this range. I hit F4 because I need to use absolute address. The next part of the range I need is this area here because this contains the market information, which will be the same for all my formulas. I hit F4 again. Next, I need this cell here that contains a property called models. I hit F4. And finally, I go back to my model sheet and I click on that cell here that will be the respective model value. And I close parentheses, I hit return. And that's my price. And I say copy and I say down here paste. And I do have all my prices. These two cells are errors because the respective cells are empty. This is an error, but there is an information here that tells me this is not possible viewing from Quantileap. And so this is explainable away. I can delete this and these three errors of the same reason. And that gives me the final option prices that depend on the inputs of the complex log formula here and the integration here. That has brought me to the end of this talk. Thank you for watching and bye.